There's less fish. Everyone said there's less fish than a few years back. There's less biodiversity. Biology student from Germany. My master's is in international studies in aquatic tropical ecology, and I've been here to do some research on my or for my master's thesis. And I've also done some work with the NGO and for the NGO. Interested in the impacts of marine environmental changes on the livelihoods of mainly fishermen and marine tourism operators. But I learned that it is very hard to get a hold of fishermen because I didn't know anyone here. I needed to find the fishermen first, which was very hard, and then they don't or not many of them speak English, so it was very hard to get in contact with them. So I changed the focus of my study a little bit to the perception of locals in general to marine environmental changes and how they perceive it and what they think can be done, because I conducted some interviews already with people from NGOs and with locals on Cuba, and there were a lot of motives that just keep coming back, like the people want to do something for the ocean but they're just helpless, and because the politics are corrupt and there's nothing they think they can do. So since this is something that I heard a lot, I think I now decided to change the focus of my study and focus on this, like how local people perceive the environment and the changing environment and what they think should be done, can be done, and maybe how the management could develop. Apart from that, I also did Project Manaia work. In the first week we were sailing a lot, and so I did a lot of snorkeling and species ID. I helped with seagrass transects, and we worked together with the NGO on Silva and 20,000 miles, and with them we also dove a lot. We did underwater cleanups, and I mean, you saw it on Instagram, and seagrass transects, and Pinna nobilis survey, snorkeling, and lots of fun stuff. I saw my first octopus. I never saw an octopus before, and I think it was the second day I was here, and I went snorkeling and I saw a freaking octopus, so this was great. And for me, seeing all the biodiversity, really, because I you know that I haven't been snorkeling or diving a lot before, so coming here and seeing all these amazing animals, I was really lucky with the weather, because the first weeks we were always in the water and snorkeling and seeing a lot of fun stuff. Seagrass, diving the seagrass transects, because I didn't think that I would be diving here, and then they offered us that we could help them, so we went with them, and just being on the sea bottom counting seagrass for meat was like, oh my god, this is what a marine biologist does. This feels amazing. And yeah, this was also very nice. Yeah, like I said, the one motive that always came back is that the politics are corrupt, that young people leave the country, and so there are only the old ones staying here, and of course then the political system won't change. What I found very interesting was what Tony said, that a few years ago the ratio from working persons to retired persons was 4-1, and now it's 1-1, and this can't go well in the long term. The pensions here for people who are retired are ridiculously low, and yeah, this won't be good in the long term, so yeah. And of course the fish is getting less, there's less fish, everyone said there's less fish than a few years back, there's less biodiversity, the fish are getting smaller. Now here in Pula we have the problem with the sea walnut, so it's an invasive species, and they are also responsible for declining fish stocks because they eat all the fish larvae. And yeah, lots of problems. But also that boats are a big problem, the big boats, not only for the fisher boats, but also the yachts and cruisers who do a lot of pollution. And because there are just tourists, they just come here and do their thing and pollute everything and just go back. And so there isn't really a point where you can reach them. So there needs to be more educational work that needs to be done, and the people need to get more aware, I think, of the impact their action have. But there's a general problem that, yeah, people just need to change their minds and be more aware of the consequences of their doing. Thank you for listening and watching, and goodbye.